Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a soggy Menominee Falls High School as we bring you Greater Metro Conference football action here on Falls Cable Access Spectrum Channel 13. We are at Menominee Falls High School for tonight's varsity matchup between the visiting West Allis Central Bulldogs and the Menominee Falls Phoenix. It is a wet one out there tonight and blustery, and it is October. We are just about to get underway here as we are under a minute on the clock. I'm Marlon Hestatune, and once again, we are Falls Cable Access, Menominee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium at Jeskowitz Petroff Field. Thanks for joining us, and we look forward to hopefully another good game here for this Phoenix club. They look to close out the season and roll into the playoffs in a strong fashion. Menominee Falls will be kicking off to start off. Owen Moser set to handle those responsibilities. This should be a fun one depending on how the wind takes it. It looks like teams have decided to switch sides. Didn't get that one right on the coin flip, I guess. So we will give them a moment here to set themselves up.
Can you give me the returner?
So Owen Moser setting himself. We'll see here. Bear with us a bit tonight. The weather not only affects the field and the conditions, but it affects our conditions also. So, Keenel Turner Baskin deep for the Bulldogs. Owen Moser set here. And we are underway. Moser's kick skips into the end zone, and we will have a touchback here for the Bulldogs to start things off.
The end zone.
Couldn't hope for much better than that, I don't think. Kicking on a night like tonight, into the wind.
Central begins his possession first and 10 at their own 20.
So we will get our first look at West Allis Central's offense. Johnny Tapia, number 45, takes the direct snap, and he tries the right side. And he is hit initially and tripped up by Hunter Stuber there for the tackle. Second and 7 after a gain of 3.
Tackle by Lattice of Menominee Falls.
Mason Lattice helped out there on the back end, but Stuber with the initial contact to slow him up. Tappy again. He'll try the middle this time. He loses his helmet, so that is blown dead when the helmet comes off.
Up the middle.
Picks up a few more. Bring up 3rd and 3, maybe 3rd and 4. Yeah, let's call it 3rd and 4 from the 26 here for the Bulldogs.
Ball out on the 26-yard line. 3rd and 4.
So now we have Alexander Rebecki in at quarterback.
Moulton flips to Turner Baskin.
Turner Baskin on that carry.
Knocked around by Mason Lattice.
Mason Lattice with another tackle.
Short of the line to gain. Bulldogs face 4th down.
Not much of a gain there, so it is 4th and 4 here for the Central Bulldogs.
Remains on the 26-yard line. 4th and 4.
And if my eyes deceive me, it seems like they have a no-punt philosophy here. Oh, Joey Webb now steps back into that punter position. But they will throw it here on 4th and 4. And his pass is complete. Caught down along the sideline across midfield by number 2, Willie Newman. And that is a 1st down for the Bulldogs. Little trickeration early here against Menominee Falls.
Number 2, Willie Newman. Stuber Cooper on the coverage.
So, first and 10 for...
Officials, timeout.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs from the Menominee Falls 47-yard
line. First and 10 Central at the Menominee Falls 47-yard line.
Julian Moulton in a quarterback. And... give to Jeremiah Brister. He is tracked down after a short gain.
Brister on the carry. Stopped by Nolan
Anderson.
Miller.
Nolan Anderson and Colton Miller combining on that one.
Short loss on the play.
A little bit of a loss there. Looks like a loss of one. So second and 11 here for the Bulldogs.
Ball lies on the 48-yard line, second and 11.
Moulton again, little reverse action there. Got some blockers for
Turner Baskin.
Turner Baskin on that carry.
Stopped by Scott.
Good pickup. See where they mark this here. Looks like he was knocked out of bounds at the Menominee Falls 39. So he's gonna be just a little short of the line to gain. Third down and let's call it two.
Ball's on the Falls 39-yard line. Third and two.
Third and two here from the Menominee Falls 39-yard line. Give to Jeremiah Brister.
Brister. Left side.
He will turn the corner on the left side and pick up the
Knock
first down. First and
Lattis.
10 now here for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 Bulldogs.
I don't think this is quite how the Falls defense was expecting this to go. Osceola Central coming in 0-8 overall, 0-6 in conference. Lost last week 43-6 to Germantown. Moulton again. And shotgun at quarterback. Thomas Dorn goes in motion. Dorn will get the ball. He is met after a short gain, driven out of bounds. Maybe a pickup of one, two.
Brought down by Miller.
Clock keeps running. Colton Miller in on the tackle on that one. And they will give him three, so second and 7 here.
Ball is spotted on the Falls 34-yard line. Second and 8.
Little change of direction, but that works out poorly for the Bulldogs. They sort of faked the pitch one way, came back the other way. Jeremiah Brister, the ball carrier, and he is met and dropped in the backfield. Mason Lattis leading the charge there.
Ball carrier Jeremiah Brister met in the backfield.
So with that loss, driving him back, loss
third
of about five,
13.
Making it third and 13 here for the Bulldogs. And the Menominee Falls 39-yard line. They will throw it. That is complete. Oh, dislodged and intercepted. Cole Gagner, right place, right time as he gets that ball. It's jarred loose. And returns it all the way down into
Bulldog territory.
First and 10 for the Phoenix from the West Dallas Central 34-yard line. Nice hit, dislodged the ball after a quick completion. Gagner right there, picks it out of the air, and a big return.
First and 10, Menominee Falls inside the Bulldog 35-yard line.
Wilson Kirshner brings the offense out onto the field.
Mason Holseth.
First down carry for number 8, Mason Holseth.
Brought down by Turner Baskin.
Holseth slides into the backfield. Nice run for him.
First and 10, Menominee Falls.
All the way down to the 24-yard line. Pickup of 10, first down, Menominee Falls. Let's give him 11 on that one, 23-yard line.
28-yard line.
You could hear our field announcer. He's off by 5. That's the 23. Holseth straight ahead, little jump move, up ahead, puts the shoulder down, and he drives forward all the way down inside the 10-yard line. First and goal for the Phoenix. Menominee Falls are making no mistake what they're going to try to do tonight. Put those helmets down in this weather.
And Wickersheim.
Drive the Bulldogs backwards and eat up ground. So here we go, first and goal.
First and goal from the 8.
First and goal from the Wasallis Central 8-yard line. They say, let's keep feeding him. Holseth straight ahead. Gets dropped just short of the goal line as Holseth takes it down to about the 1. Oh, no, they're saying he stayed up. And that is into the end zone. Menominee Falls, touchdown. Mason Holseth, 3 carries, 34 yards. And Menominee Falls first on the scoreboard.
Fans, the concession stand will close tonight at the beginning of the third quarter.
Wind is whipping pretty good. This could be a
concession stand will close tonight at the beginning of the third quarter.
Bit of an adventure here for number 41, Aiden Nottolf, one of the 2 Menominee Falls kickers.
Penalty flags on the extra point.
Oh, a little motion. Not quite sure if the falls twitched or if Central got a little antsy. It is offsides. West Dallas Central came across. Looks like Menominee Falls had a choice there. And I think
the concession stand open tonight.
They'll take this off there.
Hot chocolate, coffee,
right now, they will move up from the 2 to the 1.
This evening.
And Nodolf will get another chance here. Tysis Levich on the hold. Wet hands, slippery football. See how this one goes. Down. Nodal's kick is up.
Hutchinson.
And it is good.
Nodal. Our score, Menominee Falls 7. West Dallas Central 0.
So with that kick, Menominee Falls goes up 7-0 here.
Just for you, Tommy.
Just over 7 minutes remaining in the first quarter. And Menominee Falls first in the end zone. So 7-0 here at Menominee Falls High School. We're Falls Cable Access. I'm Marlon Hestertoon, and hopefully a wild one, but definitely a wet one tonight for us here. You can see in our wider angle shots there, the fan base isn't too extreme making it out tonight. So hopefully you're joining us online, watching us on YouTube as we bring you these football games live whenever we can. If you're joining us, thanks for joining in. If you're watching a rebroadcast, not a bad decision either. Thanks for watching then. But either way, it is Friday the 13th. It is the final game of the regular season for the Menominee Falls Phoenix. And they are taking on visiting West Dallas Central, and we are bringing it to you live here at Falls Cable Access. We are getting set here. Owen Moser ready to kick. Kendall Turner Baskin, Canal Turner Baskin. Oh, and that one, we get a stoppage from the officials. See what this is about. Maybe an extra man on the field. I'm not sure. They didn't signal, but looks like we are set. Moser puts the hand up. We are back underway. Moser drives this one back to about the 10-yard line. Baskin looking for space. Weaves his way through and ends up at about the 26-yard line, and that is where the Bulldogs will start off first and 10.
Stopped by Corey Johnson. Help from Evan Hoffman.
Johnston and Hoffman on the tackle there for the Phoenix.
The Bulldogs begin first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Bulldogs going 4 wide here. Jeremiah Brister in the backfield with quarterback Julian Moulton. Moulton on the keep, straight ahead.
Moulton,
he's able to move the pile a little bit up to the 34 yard line.
Stop made by Gagner and Lattice.
Second and two, we'll call it here. From the
second and two from the
West Dallas Central 34 yard line. Moulton takes the snap. Give to Brister over the right side. Got a little bit of space as he turns the corner 40, 45, 50. And he will step out right near midfield.
Brister, the ball carrier. He finds room on the right side.
Brister, a nice run and gain there.
Pushed out of bounds by Mason Lattice.
Mason Lattice has been all over tonight. Pushes Brister out of bounds on that one.
Bulldogs inside Falls territory.
It'll be a first and 10 here, and they are going to spot it at the Menominee Falls 48 yard line. So first and 10 for the Bulldogs.
Ball spotted at the 48-yard line of Menominee Falls.
Dallas Central been able to take a couple chunks out of this Menominee Falls defense, but weren't able to score on the first drive. We'll see what they can put together here on drive number two. Another give, trying the right side, but Menominee Falls is ready for it. That time, Brister again. Knocked out of bounds by number 24, Hunter Stuber. Loss on the play.
Short loss on the play. Takes the ball back to midfield.
So second and 12 now.
12.
Four wide. Moulton under center. Pitch to Brister, but that ball goes down on the turf.
Fumble on the play.
Looks like
recovered by the Bulldogs.
Brister able to get back on that, or
fumble covered up by Brister.
But another loss here for West Dallas Central. Not quite sure. They're calling that an incomplete pass. That's interesting. Looked like a pretty clear backwards pitch. So it'll remain and 12 as we now are on third down.
Third and 8.
Three wide receivers for Central. Three on the top, one down here. And that one's over Moulton's head all the way back to the 30 yard line where he falls on it. Now he falls, we'll down him.
Moulton falls on the snap.
Easiest sack of the year for Colton Miller.
35-yard line.
That'll be fourth and forever from the West Dallas Central 34, I think.
They'll face fourth down.
31.
31-yard line.
So fourth and 31 now here for the Bulldogs, and they are in the punt formation, but who knows, they threw it on fourth down here, last possession from this spot.
Joey Webb punts for the Bulldogs.
They will kick that away, Joey Webb on that punt.
Sislevich on the return.
Tysis Levich fields that, and he brings it all the way back into West Dallas Central territory. That is where Menominee Falls' offense will set up shop here for their second possession.
Bulldog territory. At the 46-yard line.
So it'll be first and 10 for Menominee Falls. The West Dallas Central 46-yard line. Menominee Falls second possession here in the first quarter. 4:39 on the clock. They already have a 7-0 lead. Holseth stays in the backfield with Wilson Kirshner. Holseth makes the first man miss. Big hole over the 30, 25, bounces off a man. Spins down to the 21-yard line. First down, Menominee Falls.
First and 10, Menominee Falls.
Nice run from Holseth there.
Tackle by Wickersheim.
Three wide receivers, tight end, Kirshner and Holseth in the backfield. Jalen Franklin, tight end, goes in motion, but it's Holseth again, straight ahead. Holseth,
Mason Holseth
out over the 20, almost up to the 10-yard line. We'll see where they spotted here, where he went down. They will mark it at the 11, so it will be another first down from Menominee Falls. 11-yard carry there for Holseth.
Falls on the 11-yard line. First and 10, Menominee Falls.
First and 10, they can get themselves another first down, but they've been eating the ball up in chunks here. And Holseth again, straight up the middle, and Holseth walks into the end zone. Touchdown, Menominee Falls. Two straight drives where all Kirshner had to do was turn around and hand the ball off. Mason Holseth, what is that, six carries now on the night and about 70 yards and two touchdowns. Not a bad average. Nodolf on to attempt the extra point again here. Sislevich set. Sure the hands are dry. The goal, spot, kick.
Touch.
And that is good. So 3:52 to go here in the first quarter. Menominee Falls 14. West Dallas Central 0.
Nothing.
Good start here for Menominee Falls. This is, I'm sure, what they were hoping on senior night in the weather. And it is some weather. Menominee Falls special teams getting themselves set for their third kickoff of the night already here, and we're still in the first quarter. Kendall Turner Baskin and Ackland Noack Smith deep for the Bulldogs. Owen Moser set to kick off. Noack Smith actually leads the team in receiving this year. 19 catches for 230 yards and a couple of touchdowns, but no catches so far tonight. So Salas Central has, except for a couple of plays, kept it on the ground most of the night. Owen Moser looks like he is set. So he marches that one off. Hand is up. And there goes the kick. Moser drives this one. Turner Baskin takes it from about the 15. He tries the left side, turns the corner across the 25, and he gets up close to the 30-yard line. And that is where the Bulldogs will start. First and 10 from their own 30-yard line.
Met first by Evan Hoffman. Help from Kevin Cooper.
Bulldogs have had a couple of big plays which have pushed them into Menominee Falls territory on both of their first possessions, but first drive cut off by an interception and then a couple of fumbles or a fumble and a bad snap pushing them backwards and killing both of those drives. So third drive here. Looks like Joey Webb in a quarter. Moulton still in. Webb though with the snap, he will throw it deep. And that is too strong, intended for number two, Willie Newman.
Covered for the Falls by Tristan Hansen.
Tristan Hansen, number 12, on the coverage there for Menominee Falls. So he was running stride for stride with the receiver. Second and 10 now for the Bulldogs.
Second and 10 from the 30-yard line.
Moulton and Webb set up in the backfield. Four wide receivers. Moulton fakes with the keep, but he is ran down from behind by Hunter Stuber. Stuber wraps him up and drops him. Loss on the play. Third and long now for the Bulldogs. Good pursuit by Stuber there. Not buying the fake. Tracking Moulton down. Third and 14 now for the Bulldogs. On their own 27-yard line. 26. Moulton and Webb in the backfield. Little play action, and Moulton lobs that one up.
Pass is incomplete.
Intended for Johnny Tapia.
Intended for Tapia.
Coverage by Mason Lattice.
Miami Falls by Mason Lattice.
Good defensive positioning there for the Phoenix. Fourth and 14.
26-yard line.
Webb set up in the punting position. We'll see what Bulldogs have in mind here. Running some people in late. And we are set. So Webb takes a snap, gets it away. Good kick.
Sislevich
on the return takes that from.
Forced out of bounds by Webb. First and 10 Menominee Falls at their own 38-yard line. Let's take the Menominee Falls offensive line.
About a 45-yard punt there for Webb.
The left tackle, number 65, Dylan Jaganinski.
Return of about 12, and Menominee Falls will start first and 10 from their own 38-yard line.
The center, number 73, Stephen Scott. The right guard, 66, Cooper O'Million. And the right tackle, 72, Joe Sadowski.
Kirshner and Holseth setting up. Set up in the backfield again.
Timeout. Bulldogs.
Timeout for Whack here. We are 2:28 remaining here in the first quarter. Your score, Menominee Falls 14, West Allis Central nothing. Menominee Falls about to take their third possession, starting at their own 38-yard line. Thanks for joining us. This is Falls Cable Access Spectrum, Channel 13. Maybe you're staying home and dry, watching us live on YouTube tonight. If so, welcome in. Thanks for joining us. And if not, you're watching a rebroadcast on YouTube, we welcome you there too. It is Friday the 13th here at Menominee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium. A blustery and wet October evening. Perfect night for football. Last regular season game and senior night here for the Phoenix. And so far, they have controlled this one 100%. A couple of plays that pushed the ball a little bit from West Allis Central, but other than that, Menominee Falls has kept their offense quiet. And the Menominee Falls offense has basically been comprised of Mason Holseth, as he has carried the ball every single play and scored both touchdowns so far. Joey Cook, the lead tailback, on the sideline close. Kirshner on the keep. He rolls right. Lost that one over the middle. Just a little bit. Just a little bit out of the reach of Scotty Hawkins. Second and 10 now for the Phoenix.
Second and 10 from the 38.
Kirshner and Holseth. Jalen Franklin, number 80, in the tight end spot, goes in motion. And give this to Holseth and straight ahead. And he has tripped up after a pickup of Holseth two on that one. So that'll be third and eight now for the Phoenix.
Met first by Sanders.
Clock continues to run as we're about to dip under 2 minutes here in the first quarter.
Miami Falls, 40-yard line. Third and eight.
Here we go, third and eight. Three wide receivers. Piefer, Hawkins, and Johnson. Kirshner rolls right, and he will keep as he turns the corner on the right side. Kirshner straight ahead then.
Wilson Kirshner off the right side.
Looks like he's going to be just short. He's going to be spotted at about the
46-yard
line. 47. About a half yard short. See what Menominee Falls has in mind here. Looks like the offense is going to stay on the field. Fourth and one now for the Phoenix. Good confidence in their offense so far to be able to get a yard. That's his give to Holseth straight ahead, and he will pick up that first down as he crosses midfield. First and ten, Menominee Falls.
Inside Bulldog territory.
Keep that clock running. Keep those chains moving. Another Menominee Falls first down. They are right at midfield. My apologies. He might have gotten there, but he didn't quite break into Bulldog territory. So first and 10 now for the Phoenix. Kirshner sets with three wide receivers. Running back in the backfield. Kirshner keeps, rolls right. Kirshner's pass complete down to the 40-yard line. Corey Johnson on the reception. See where they spot this. Which side of the 40 they put it on? And that is to the 39, so first and 10, Menominee Falls. Move those chains.
Officials timeout.
Officials calling timeout on the field. I think the chains were a little slow to move. They're wet and cold tonight too, so. Here we go, first quarter, under 20 seconds. And Menominee Falls will snap once more. Holseth bounces to the outside. Tries to turn it, but he is
Mason Holseth on the carry.
Met and dropped there by Joey Webb.
Stopped by Webb.
Short pickup, and that's going to bring an end to the first quarter here. 2-1, and there's the horn. So, 12 minutes gone. Your score, Menominee Falls 14, West Allis Central 0. Second quarter coming up in just a minute or two here.
That's the end of our first quarter. Our score, Menominee Falls 14, West Allis Central. Nothing.
I have a feeling the officials will keep this game moving within the rules and regulations for how much time they have to allot. All right, we are set. Officials tell us they're about ready. Second and 9 for Menominee Falls from the Bulldog 38-yard line.
Second and 9 from the 38.
Kirshner keeps, goes right. Kirshner down across the 30.
Wilson Kirshner
rumbles ahead to the 25-yard line. First down, Menominee Falls.
First and 10, Menominee Falls.
Menominee Falls keeping the chains and the clock moving.
Spot the ball at the 26-yard line.
Menominee Falls with their standard three-receiver package. Holseth in the backfield with Kirshner. Kirshner takes, rolls right, throws it deep, and he connects.
Wilson Kirshner.
Scotty Hawkins. 26 yards, Menominee Falls. Touchdown. That was a nice throw in these conditions from Kirshner to drop that right in the basket there for Hawkins. Menominee Falls tacks on, now 20-0. Here at the start of the second quarter. Sislevich and Nodolf all set to attempt this extra point. Nodolf a set. Sislevich calls for it. And kick is up. And it is good.
Sislevich.
So 11 minutes, 25 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Menominee Falls 21, West Allis Central 0. So the Phoenix come into tonight's game 5-3 overall, 4-2 in conference. It's good for third in the Greater Metro Conference. Their only losses, they lost last week to Sussex Hamilton. No big deal. They're only ranked third in state in Division I. Prior to that, to Marquette. They're ranked 8th in state in Division 1. And their other loss, their opening game of the season to Slinger in a shootout. Slinger, good solid football team, and first game under a new head coach and a new offense, and they put 41 points on the board. So, pretty solid, pretty positive season here for Menominee Falls, and they are set to move into the playoffs. Should receive a decent seed. It'll be interesting to see as that will be announced over this weekend. Regions and seeds. I think on Sunday I've seen those will be coming out.
Right now, hot chocolate, coffee, and hand warmers all available.
Moser's kick heads down.
Oh, and Moser's kickoff was out of bounds.
And it will go out of bounds at the 8-yard line, so.
Central begins this drive at their own 35-yard line.
Brookfield Central, West Ellis Central brings the ball out. They'll get to start at the 35-yard line. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Their best field position of the night so far from a starting point. Julian Moulton comes out. He will be under center again this drive for the Bulldogs. Jeremiah Brister in the backfield. Willie Newman split to the side. They go in motion. Three wide receivers up top. A little bunch formation. Moulton calls for it. Give on the reverse.
Noack Smith
brings that around. Gets up near midfield. That'll be a first down for the Bulldogs. Looks like they're going to spot this at the 47-yard line. First and 10 from their own 47.
The carry takes the ball to the 47-yard line of Central. First and 10.
Moulton calls for it, takes the snap. Straight ahead give to Brister. Brister then bounces it to the right. And he is chased to the sideline and out of bounds by Cole Gagnier. Short gain for
Brister the carry.
Bulldog running back.
Knocked out of bounds by Gagnier.
He'll just cross midfield to the Menominee Falls 49-yard line.
Ball's at the Menominee Falls 49-yard line.
Second and 6 now for the Bulldogs.
Second and 6.
Moulton on the keep straight ahead. Puts his helmet down and his Moulton line pushes, keeper. But he has eventually stopped and stood up right at about the 45-yard line. That'll bring up 3rd and 2 now for the Bulldogs.
Hit by Miller. Help from Mettinger.
Miller and Mettinger in on the tackle there for
Ball's
him when he falls.
45-yard line. 3rd and 2.
Third down here for Menominee Falls, trying to get the stop. This is about as far as the Bulldogs have pushed into Menominee Falls territory. Marcella Central wants to talk about it, make sure they've got the right play called here. 10:29 currently on the clock here in the second quarter. Menominee Falls leading 21-0. Menominee Falls looking for their 6th win overall, their 5th win in conference, and Bulldogs trying to find a way to earn their first victory of the season this year. So here we go, 3rd and 2 for the Bulldogs. Moulton with Brister, and the give is to Brister, and he is met in backfield, but he slips that tackle, and he will slide up to about the 41-yard line. First down for the Bulldogs. Nice job avoiding that first tackle as he did have some traffic in the backfield right away.
first and 10 Bulldogs at their Menominee Falls 41-yard line.
So here we go, first and 10 from the 41. Moulton gives to Brister, tries the right side. And that ball is loose.
Fumble on the play.
Colton Miller
on the play.
Falls on the loose ball for the Phoenix, but there is a flag
fumble
on the field.
Recovered by Colton Miller.
See what the flag is all about here before we get too excited. We have holding against the Bulldogs, so that will be Menominee Falls first and 10 from their own 36-yard line. Another turnover here for the Bulldogs.
36-yard line.
And Menominee Falls will go back on offense with 9:51 remaining in the second quarter. Already up 21-0 and looking to add. Bulldogs a little late running somebody on. Kirshner takes a snap, tries the right side out across the 40, up ahead to about the 43-yard line. Pick up a 7, second and 3 now for the Phoenix. Bulldogs were late getting their defenders on there for that one. Fortunate that the play didn't roll into where those missing defenders were, but now he falls with a good first down carry. Second and short for the Phoenix. And he falls 3 wide with tight end, goes in motion. Holseth in the backfield with Kirshner, and the give is to Holseth, who's straight ahead, up across the midfield to the 50, the 45. Holseth spins, still on his feet, down to the 41-yard line of West Dallas Central. First down, Menominee Falls.
First and 10 Falls inside the 45-yard line. Brought down by Wickersheim and Galvez. Ball's on the 41-yard line.
Mason Holseth doing a nice job of dragging tacklers with him tonight, breaking arm tackles, earning every yard that he's gotten. There's a lot so far. He's got to be close to 100 yards already. Give once again to Holseth all across the 40, 35. Holseth down to the 31-yard line. We'll see where they spot it, but it should be another first down. Let's give it a moment here.
Brought down by Smith Jr., Noack Smith, and Mims. First and 10, Menominee Falls.
That is 10 more yards, and Menominee Falls, first down. Wind picks up, rain stings a little bit more, and Menominee Falls keeps marching. Motion from the tight end. Holseth straight ahead again, 25-20.
Holseth, the ball carrier.
Upended there by Turner Baskin, down at the 19-yard line. Another first and 10 for Menominee Falls.
First and 10, Menominee Falls. Ball lies on the 19-yard line.
Kirshner and Holseth, 3 wide receivers. Tight end goes in motion. Keep it going. Holseth straight ahead, 10, 5, stiff arm. And he's met there and gang tackled.
Mason Holseth.
Keneal Turner-Baskin and
tackle made by Turner
Aiden Wickersheim combining on that tackle, but not before Mason Holseth with another Menominee Falls first down, first and goal from the 5-yard line.
First and goal, Menominee Falls at the 5-yard line.
CJ Spence checks in for the Phoenix at running back. Spence with the carry. He is met and dropped in the backfield by number 7, Jacob Sanders. Nice penetration, nice play there by Sanders.
Met by Jacob Sanders.
Second and goal here for the Phoenix.
Short loss on the play.
They will cost him a yard on that one, but it's still second and goal, this time from the 6.
Second and goal from the 6.
Kirshner keeps, rolls right, throws back across his body. Oh!
Kirshner's pass falls incomplete in the end zone.
Scotty Hawkins unable to hold on to that one. It'll bring up third and goal for the Phoenix. He had him hit Hawkins in a good spot. Hawkins unable to hold on this wet night. So third and goal here for Menominee Falls.
Third and goal from the six.
Holseth back in at running back. And that is the give Holseth off the left side, and he is able to walk his way into the end zone. Menominee Falls, touchdown. That's the third one of the night for Holseth. As Menominee Falls now jumps up to 27-0 lead with the extra point upcoming. Aiden Nodolf on again. His fourth extra point of the night. Tysis Levich set to hold. Hands are dry. Here's the call. Snap. Hold. Kick. And it is good. 28-0. 6:18 remaining in the second quarter. Menominee Falls continues
West Allis Central
to put points on the board here against West Allis Central. And 6:18 remaining in the second quarter, and your score, Menominee Falls 28, West Allis Central 0. This is Falls Cable Access Spectrum, Channel 14. Thanks for joining us. If you stayed home tonight and you're watching live on YouTube, that might have been the right decision. But either way, hope you're enjoying the game. Plenty of football left here in the evening. We are not even quite halfway done with the second quarter.
Returned by Turner Baskin. Hit hard by Corey Johnson.
West Allis Central set to take over here, this time from their own 13-yard line.
First and 10 Bulldogs at their own 18-yard line.
So here the Bulldogs set up first and 10 from their own 18-yard line. Snap to Moulton. Keeps it himself, but there is nothing there. Loses two, second and 12.
Moulton keeps. Hit by Colton Miller.
Colton Miller in the backfield. Disrupting, as he's done all season long. Miller leads the team in total tackles coming into tonight, and he's tied for the team lead in sacks.
Second,
so
12.
He is always around the ball, and he is in the backfield. Second and 12 for the Bulldogs. Moulton takes, looks and fires to his right, and that falls in amongst the Menominee Falls defenders, intended for number one, Kenile Turner Baskin, but not there. Cole Gagner on the coverage.
Dorn.
I think the Bulldogs were lucky to come away with still possessing the ball on that one.
Third and 12 from the 16.
Third and 12 now for West Allis Central from their own 16-yard line. Four wide receivers. Brister in the backfield with Moulton. Moulton drops, throws. pass intended for Aiklin Noack Smith. A little bit high.
Aiklin's pass falls incomplete, intended for Noack Smith.
Now we'll bring up 4th and 12 for the Bulldogs.
For Menominee Falls by Mason Lattice.
Mason Lattice on the coverage. He has been everywhere tonight.
Face 4th for this and Falls 12 defense. At their own 16.
See what the Bulldogs have in mind here, but 4th and 12 from your own 16. Like number 8, Maurice Smith Jr. deep in the punter position, but
flags in the field.
A little bit of laundry on the field. Let's see what this is about. Nope, no flag. Timeout called by Menominee Falls. So with 5:25.
There is no flag on the play. Timeout, Menominee Falls.
5:25 remaining here in the second quarter. Falls leading West Ellis Central 28-0. 4th and 12 for West Ellis Central from their own 16-yard line, so we would expect an upcoming punt here, but we will see. Tysus Levitch drops into that deep safety position for Menominee Falls. In case you missed it, West Ellis Central already did a fake punt deep in their own end in the first quarter on their first possession and converted. But this feels just a little too deep to try anything tricky here. But we'll see. Maurice Smith Jr. deep, rocking the pink socks.
Noack Smith back to punt for Central. Sislevich in deep position.
I'm sorry, Aiklin Noack Smith, not in his punt. Out to West Ellis Central, 44-yard line. And it'll be down there by number 2, Willie Newman. First and 10 for the Phoenix. Their best, well, no, not their best starting field position. The interception earlier put them a little bit deeper into West Ellis Central territory.
First and 10 for the 44.
5:14 remaining. Menominee Falls sets up shop. Kirshner and Holseth with Cade Kosnick in a tight end as he goes in motion.
Whistles before the play.
And West Ellis Central takes their third timeout of the half just before the snap. House DJ showing a sense of humor tonight with the rain-induced music. It wouldn't be football on Friday night in Wisconsin without at least one cold, wet, and rainy game on the season for every club. Although this, some of the threats of some of the more severe weather was potentially going to wreak havoc on some of the other games around the state for teams trying to get that last qualifying win to get into the playoffs. So some teams around the state moved times up, played games earlier because they didn't want to chance the thunderstorms rolling in. All information was that if the game wasn't finished by fairly early tomorrow, it wouldn't count on the season record. It could endanger some seasons. So here we go, first and 10 for the Falls. Kirshner fakes, keeps, rolls right. Little pitch to Holseth, who has done it all tonight. Holseth down across the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Holseth. Touchdown, Menominee Falls.
Menominee Falls, Patert.
Mason Holseth is the Swiss Army knife tonight. Carries, catches, yards, touchdowns, as that is his 4th touchdown of the evening. That one coming by way of pass from Wilson Kirshner. 44 yards and a cloud of dust. Do you get to say cloud of dust for a 44-yard gain? I'm gonna. All right, Aiden Adolf on his 5th extra point of the night. Sislevich once again on to hold. He's set. Snap, hold, kick. And this one is good also. 35-0 Menominee Falls.
Our score, Menominee Falls.
5 minutes remaining.
West Dallas Central, nothing.
That possession took Menominee Falls 23 seconds to score on that one. So we have 5 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Owen Moser warming that leg up, getting ready to kick it deep. New faces returning for West Dallas Central. Acklin Noack Smith, number 9. Number 31, Camarion Johnson, deep for the Bulldogs. Owen Moser set to kick for Menominee Falls.
Moser kicks for the Falls.
He drives that one away, and that one will sail over everybody's head and find the end zone for a touchback.
The Bulldogs begin this drive first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
So we'll bring it out to the 20, and that is where West Dallas Central will set up shop. Thanks for joining us here. Falls Cable Access, Spectrum, Channel 13. We are at Menominee Falls High School, Schuman Stadium, Petrov Jeskowitz Field. It is rainy, it is wet, it is windy. But we are here bringing you boys Greater Metro Conference football, visiting West Dallas Central Bulldogs and the Menominee Falls Phoenix. Menominee Falls has controlled this one, currently leading 35-0 as we march towards halftime.
Moulton, the keeper.
Moulton straight ahead on that one. Moves it forward and then gets driven back. So they spot it up at the 23-yard line, where they'll give them forward progress. Second and 7 for the Bulldogs.
Stop by Lattice and Rob Green.
Robert Green right in the middle of things there. Being the first one through the door on that stop of Moulton. Second and 7. Moulton and Brister in the backfield, 4 wide receivers. Moulton the snap, pitches to the right side to Brister as he tries to turn the corner.
Brister the ball carrier.
Not much there as he is escorted out of bounds by Nolan Anderson. Maybe a pickup of 1. Bring up 3rd and 6 here for the Bulldogs.
Third and 7 from the 23.
I'll give him no gain, so 3rd and 7. Moulton looks to throw to the right. That gets tipped at the line and going nowhere.
Moulton's fastball's incomplete.
Looked to have been intended for number 88, Thomas Dorn, as he was the man out wide out here.
Coverage by Wolper.
Noack Smith might have been hidden underneath where I couldn't see him. Might have also been the plan, but that one falls incomplete. So 4th and 6 now for the Bulldogs. Clock keeps running here as we get under 3 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Acklin Noack Smith deep in that punt formation. Menominee Falls staying in coverage for the most part. That one's on the ground. Acklin Smith unable to do anything with it. And Menominee Falls finds and drops.
Smith Jr. stopping the backfield. Hit by Stuber.
Hunter Stuber, another name we've called a bunch tonight. Active in the backfield, makes the tackle, and it is a turnover on downs for Menominee Falls.
At the Bulldog 24-yard line.
That'll be 1st and 10. West Dallas Central, 24-yard line. 2 minutes here as the clock is running. Not what the Bulldogs wanted there on that punt opportunity. Kirshner and Holseth in the backfield. Kirshner keeps, tries the right side, cuts it back a little bit.
Kirshner on the keeper.
Inside the 15, down to the 13-yard line. Second down from Menominee Falls.
Stop by Wickersheim.
Should be about second and five or six, roughly.
Ball lies on the 13-yard line. Second. Five.
Second and five. Clock down to a minute 20. Kirshner with the give to Holseth. Holseth up the middle. And he gets ridden down just short of the first down,
Mason
it looks
Holseth,
like.
Ball carrier.
So that'll be third and one.
Hit by
Juan Pinero on the tackle. So he jumped on Holseth's back and took him to the ground on that one. So we're about to dip under a minute here for Menominee Falls in the second quarter.
Second and one from the 10. Check that third down.
That was Colton Miller on the carry for Menominee Falls. And he
hit by Sanders.
Didn't quite get there, so it'll be fourth and one
fourth
for the
down,
Phoenix.
Menominee Falls inside the 10 at the 9-yard line.
See what they do here. They have to snap the ball at least once more.
Fourth and one.
Kirshner with the keep, rolls right. Finds Colton Miller.
Colton Miller
rumbles into the end zone. Menominee Falls touchdown.
Menominee Falls.
Giving the defensive focus senior an opportunity to get his hands on the ball there. So Menominee Falls extends the lead 41 to nothing at this point in time. Aiden Nodolf on to attempt extra point number six. Snap, hold, kick, and it is good. 42-0, 16 seconds remaining here in the second quarter as we march towards halftime. We're here at senior night at Menominee Falls High School, and the seniors are showing out for the Phoenix as they lead the West Dallas Central Bulldogs 42-0. Mason Holseth, the usually running back, but with Joey Cook out tonight, giving him an opportunity to carry the ball for Menominee Falls. Four touchdowns, well over 100 yards in this first half. Colton Miller, senior linebacker, just scored a touchdown for the Phoenix offense. A pretty positive night for these young men so far as we march towards halftime. Again, 16 seconds remaining. Kickoff upcoming. Owen Moser marks off his steps.
Moser kicks for the Falls.
And kicks it away. Again, just puts it
off through the end zone.
Through the end zone. And
Bulldogs begin this drive. First and 10.
West Dallas Central will start first and 10 from their own 20-yard line. See if Coach Haywood has anything in mind here for the last 16 seconds or if he'll take it to halftime where we're at. Expecting we'll see pretty serious substitutions from Coach Regent Smith here in the second half as we come out. For those of you unaware, we will have a running clock in the second half also. As long as the score stays of a differential of 35 points or more, the clock will run nonstop through the third and fourth quarters. But if West Dallas Central can close that gap to less than 35 points, we'll go back to standard clock timing. West Dallas Central with the reverse, but that is sniffed out.
Murray Smith Jr. on ball carrier.
Noack Smith caught in the backfield and dropped.
And that's the half of tonight's senior night contest.
So, as the horn blows,
nothing.
Your score, Menominee Falls 42, West Dallas Central 0. Halftime coming up. We'll be back with the third quarter in just a little bit.
Team performance, also the senior cheerleaders.
Stick around as the dance and cheer teams will perform at halftime. Their own opportunity to get out in the rain a little bit. So thanks again for joining us, everybody. Falls Cable Access here. Menomonee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium. I'm Marlon Hestatoon, and it is senior night. Last home game, last regular season game of the season for the Falls Phoenix. And your halftime score, Menomonee Falls 42, West Ellis Central 0. See you back here in about 20 minutes.
Fans, it's time. Please direct your attention to the field as head coach Chelsea Bushman presents the 2023-24 varsity dance team. Performing this evening to Rain on Me. It's a theme we have going up here. Danica Ardinelli, Aubrey Langer, Lauren Hilbelink, Aaliyah McKenzie, Lily Meadows, Isabella Montanez.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here coming to you, Menomonee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium, Jeskiewicz Field. And this is Menomonee Falls High School football visiting West Ellis Central, set to kick off here to start the second half. This will be the first kick return for Menomonee Falls tonight, as they controlled the entire first half, leading 42 to nothing after 24 minutes of football. Angelo Cruz set to kick it off. Beeks and Sislevich deep for the Phoenix. A little short pop-up kick taken at about the 31-yard line there. Hunter Stuber down around the edge. Crosses midfield all the way up to the 42-yard line, and that inside is where Menomonee Falls gets to go to work.
The 40-yard line. Tackle made by Contney.
All right, let's call it the 43. Looks like they're going to mark him at, but excellent field position here for Menomonee Falls to start off this second half. Pretty much right where they ended the second half, or the first half. So we got some new folks in here. Oh, bad snap.
Come on, play recovered by the Falls.
Sean Grace unable to fall on that one for Menomonee Falls. Short loss
by Sean Grayson.
CJ Spence in the backfield now for Menomonee Falls. Mitchell Hutchinson, sophomore quarterback for the Phoenix, taking over here in the third quarter. So second and 13. Give straight ahead to Spence. Pickup of one on that one. That'll be third and 12 now.
Hit made by Pinero.
Pinero in on the tackle for the Bulldogs.
third and 12.
So it'll be third and 12 here. Good opportunity for Hutchinson to show us what he can do from a quarterback perspective. Snaps, rolls right. Pursuit is on as he looks.
Mitchell Hutchinson's pass is incomplete.
He lofts it down. Intended for number 86, Kevin Cooper.
Covered up for the Bulldogs by Sharp.
Sails out of bounds. So that'll make it fourth and 12 here for the Phoenix.
Fourth and 12 from the 45. Galva's back for the Bulldogs. Eli Elm in the punt.
Eli Elm will handle the punting duties here for Menominee Falls. This will be his first punt of the evening. Elm gets that one away under some pressure, but that downed at about the 12-yard line.
Well, it's covered up inside the 15-yard line.
Covered up by number 31, Camarion Johnson, and that is where the Bulldogs will start. Once again, just a reminder to everybody, as you're watching the scoreboard, you are not mistaken, the clock is running. Because Menominee Falls has a 35-point differential here in the second half, we will have a running clock until West Ellis Central can close that gap and make it less than 35 points. Moulton and Brister will start here in the third quarter in the backfield for West Ellis Central. Little quick out there from Moulton. Caught by Eklund Noack Smith as he is dropped at the 20-yard line.
Tackled by Hansen and Hoffman.
They're going to give him the 21, so that'll be second and one here.
Second and one from the 21.
Little cluster of receivers up top. Willie Newman split wide down here on the near side. Moulton and Brister in the backfield. There's that little start one direction, come back the other way from Brister.
Brister on the end around.
He picks up.
Looks
like anything. They're going to keep him right at the 21, knocked out of bounds. Corvan Namini there on the tackle.
No gain on the play.
Third and one now for the Bulldogs.
Third and one. On the 21.
Turner Baskin goes in motion. Brister the give off the right side. He turns the corner across the 25 to the 30. Up across the 35.
Brister off the right edge.
Did step out. Couldn't quite tell from our angle where they're going to mark him at.
By Sebastian.
It's right there, spotting him right at the 40-yard line. So pickup of 19 for Brister on that carry. That'll be good for a first down for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 central at their own 40-yard line.
Little touch pass there from Moulton.
Wickersheim, the ball carrier.
Aiden Wickersheim.
Met and dropped by Evan Hoffman.
Evan Hoffman. It's a nice tackle there. Stopping them after a gain of one. Second and nine now for the Bulldogs. Receivers and a tight end. Moulton gives to Brister. Brister to the right across the 40. It's up to the 45. That midfield. 45-40. 35-30. 25-20. 15-10. And he is dragged
Brister
down.
Brister has room on the right edge.
short of the goal line, going to be out at about the 3-yard line.
Brought down by Beeks of the Falls inside the 5-yard line.
Now they're going to give him the one, first and goal for West Ellis Central.
Timeout
on the field here. West Ellis Central knocking at the door from the 1-yard line. First and goal. Mamani Falls leads here in the third quarter with 4:55 remaining in that quarter. 42-0 at this point in time. Officials tell everybody to get back in place. We're about to get back underway. And set. It's a snap. Give it to the big guy in the backfield. Hand off to Aiden Kerwin, offensive lineman.
Aiden Kerwin.
That was a lot to stop on that carry, and Menominee Falls unable to do it, so West Ellis Central on the scoreboard. Your score now, Menominee Falls 42, West Ellis Central 6. Aiden Kerwin, the big senior offensive lineman, getting the opportunity there to get into the end zone in what most likely is his last high school game. Gotta admit it, pretty cool for him. Good job there, Coach Haywood, on that play call. So here we go with the extra point. Angelo Cruz set to take this extra point. Hold it down, kick is up, and he is good.
The extra point by Cruz is good.
Score now, Menominee Falls 42, West Ellis Central 7. And the Bulldogs will be set to kick off here. Both clubs giving senior players an opportunity who don't usually touch the ball to score tonight. Colton Miller for the Phoenix, picking up the touchdown at the end of the second quarter. Aiden Kerwin there with the touchdown for the Bulldogs. Angelo Cruz set to kick off here after that score from West Ellis Central. 4:47 remaining in the third quarter. Thanks for joining us. This is Falls Cable Access, bringing you Menominee Falls football at Menominee Falls High School for the season finale between the visiting West Ellis Central Bulldogs and the Menominee Falls Phoenix. And Cruz's kick goes into the end zone, where it will be a touchback for the Phoenix.
Menominee Falls begins first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
You know, if you want to philosophize a little bit about what we just saw there, tonight is more than likely the last high school game for probably literally thousands of kids across the state of Wisconsin. Their team won't go on to play in the playoffs. Maybe they're hurt, maybe whatever it is, but this is the last regular season game, so this is an important night for a lot of these young men. So the coach having the forethought there to give an opportunity to one of his seniors who contributes on the team in a way that doesn't allow him to score like that, I really appreciate that, and I think it's a great choice. Menominee Falls struggling a little bit here in the second half.
Hutchinson
not able to handle that snap, and he takes the loss.
Met first by Sanders.
All the way back to the 9-yard line. That'll make it.
And Pinero.
Second and 21 now for the Phoenix. Hutchinson here set. Kind of losing in on 4 minutes. Give straight ahead to C.J. Spence. Short gain. That'll be third and long now for the Phoenix. See what Menominee Falls does here. Coach Regent Smith hasn't necessarily opened the playbook too much to Hutchinson here in his couple of opportunities in the second half. So. Hutchinson rolls right on the keep, turns the corner, gets up to about the 13, 14 yard line where he is rolled out of bounds and he is slow to get up.
Tackle for the Bulldogs made by Wickersheim.
Hutchinson limping his way under his own power but down to the Menominee Falls sideline. Wickersheim on that tackle. Looks like he got rolled up on his knee a little bit there as he was brought to the turf. Eli Elm will come out, punt this one away.
Now, Menominee Falls faces fourth down at 17 at their own 13-yard line.
Jeremiah Brister and Camarion Johnson deep for West Ellis Central on this punt as Eli Elm sets up from his own 2-yard line. Low
Johnson
snap.
And Brister back in return.
Elm
formation.
Gets it away though. Short punt. Taking my Brister at about the 32. Brister to the 30, 20, 15, 10. Makes a move, cuts back in, and Brister is into the end zone.
Touchdown.
Just like that, Burfield Central, two quick scores, making it now 42 to 13, Menominee Falls. 35. So Menominee Falls, a little confusion. Is there an extra point defense team, a little slow getting out on the field there. But not to be outmatched, so is West Ellis Central. So we'll have the upcoming extra point here.
And timeout on the field.
Now we have a timeout on the field. So everybody wants to talk about it. Coach Regent Smith rallying his troops, reminding them that they're still playing a game here, and they head out to cover this extra point attempt. Angelo Cruz will be on to attempt this extra point again. Aiden Wickersheim to hold for the Bulldogs. Oh, bad snap. Angelo Cruz tries to make the best of it, but he is ridden out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Unable to get into the end zone. So, 2:18 left here in the third quarter. Your score. Menominee Falls 42, West Dallas Central 13.
Short of the line to gain, stopped by Joel Wolbert. Our score, Menominee Falls 42, West Dallas Central 13.
Looking at the Menominee Falls sideline with that injury to Hutchinson. See Wilson Kirshner warming back up for Menominee Falls. Looks like he'll come back into the game. Steer this one home. And West Dallas Central have another opportunity to kick off to the Phoenix. This Sunday, the WIA will announce their brackets and their matchups for the first round of the football playoffs. It'll be exciting to see where Menominee Falls lands in that. Probably a pretty good opportunity that they'll have a home game, but we'll have to see which bracket they land in. Past years, they've ended up in the northern bracket with some Fox Valley schools and the like, so we'll see where they land this year in that Division II bracket.
Beeks and Sislevich back in return formation.
Beeks and Sislevich deep.
Cruz kicks for the Bulldogs.
Cruz set to kick. He kicks that one away. Beeks takes that one from the 10, 15, 20, 25 to the outside. Gets up to about the 29-yard line. And that is where, 28, that's where Menominee Falls will start this one off.
Sanders of Central.
And Wilson Kirshner does make
Falls
a
29-yard line.
Reappearance.
First and 10 Falls.
Try to do his best to chip away at this clock and bring this game to a closure as we've got 2:13 remaining here in the third quarter. Straight ahead give.
Mason Holseth.
Holseth back in also as he
toward midfield, hit by
pushes that one ahead for 20 yards and Menominee Falls first down. I think Coach Regent Smith had seen enough with West Ellis Central scoring in those two quick possessions and said, let's put some people out there to push back a little bit from an offensive standpoint as Holseth and Kirshner both come back in. Kirshner takes a snap, rolls right, looks downfield, nobody home, so he will keep it himself across midfield, 45. Up ahead to about the 41-yard line. Should be good for another first down. See where they mark him after he steps out.
Close to the Bulldog 40-yard line.
And it will be good as he heads up to the Bulldog 41-yard line. First and 10, Menominee Falls.
First and 10, Menominee Falls at the Bulldog 41-yard line.
Menominee Falls has rolled pretty much the entire starting offense out here as Pfeiffer, Johnson, and Hawkins all in at receiver. Holseth in at running back. Kirshner makes a man miss, looks deep, launches that one down there, and that is, they're calling it incomplete on the ground. Keneal Turner-Baskin looked like he might have.
It was intercepted.
Oh, no, they have reversed it.
At the point of interception.
Interception for West Ellis Central. Turner Baskin comes away with that one. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Deep in their own territory, they will start out at about the 5-yard line. But just like on the offense, a lot of those starting defensive numbers back out there for Menominee Falls here also. So we'll see what the plan is. 1:26 in the third quarter. Brookfield Center, West Ellis Central takes over at their own 5-yard line, first and 10. Give to Brister. He tries the right side. Nowhere to go. He loses a couple on that one. It'll make it second and 11 or 12, depending on where they actually spot him, where he stepped out. Nice job of stringing that one out.
Ball lies on the 3-yard line of Central.
So second and 12 from their own 3-yard line.
Second and 13.
Zero. West Dallas Central, second and 12 from their own 3-yard line. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide as the Falls defense swarms to the ball. James Davis Jr. in at that quarterback position, and he is swamped on that one.
Tackle by Holseth. Help from Namini.
Another loss of one on that, so it is now third and 13 from the 2 yard
line. Third and 13 from the 2 yard line.
Davis Jr. stays in at quarterback. Offset by Jeremiah Brister in the backfield. Four wide receivers. Menominee Falls coming after him. He looks, throws, that is incomplete, but we do have a flag.
Flags on the play.
We'll see what this one is. Holding on the offense. And they're calling the safety, automatic safety, because the hold happened in the end zone. Fortunate mistake from the offensive line there. So we should have a score of 44-13 now for Menominee Falls.
The penalty is holding on the Bulldogs in the end zone that results in a safety for Menominee Falls.
So Menominee Falls.
Our score, Menominee Falls 44, West Dallas Central.
Gets a couple more points and gets the ball back coming up here. Sislevich and Laquan Beeks head deep for Menominee Falls. We have under 30 seconds here remaining in the third quarter. Osceola Central about to kick the ball away to Menominee Falls after that safety, which comes on the holding in the end zone call against them. Angelo Cruz will continue to handle the kicking responsibilities here for West Dallas Central. Cruz, long run up as he will kick here from the 20. He kicks that away. Nice kick. Beeks lets it skip by. Oh, he's got to go get that. That is a live ball. Oh, can't get his hands at it, but finally falls on it. Back at the 10-yard line. So Menominee Falls will take possession from their own 10. Just like a standard kickoff, the kicks on safeties, also live ball. So Beeks couldn't afford to allow that to bounce around. If West Dallas Central falls on it, it would have been their possession. So Menominee Falls starting off first and 10 from their own 10-yard line. Wilson Kirshner and Mason Holseth back out in the end zone. Piefer, Hawkins, and Johnson, the receiver. And Cade Kosnick, radiant at tight end. Kirshner keeps, tries the right side as he turns the corner across the 10, 15 to the 20. Hit. Spun and he goes down. Ball is out. West Dallas Central saying they've got it, and the refs agree. West Dallas Central takes over, recovered by number 45, Johnny Tapia.
Covered up by Johnny Tapia.
That recovery is at the Menominee Falls 31 yard line, and that West Dallas Central will take over there.
First and 10 Bulldogs at the Falls 31 yard line.
Menominee Falls right back on defense after a nice three and out down in the end zone, ending in the safety. James Davis Jr. still in at quarterback. Here comes that reverse. Once again, run to Acklin Nowak Smith.
Nowak Smith on the end around. Brought down by Lattice and Gagner.
Pickup of about three, and that will bring us to the end of the third quarter. Your score, Menominee Falls 44. Brookfield Central 13.
Brookfield Central 13.
You're watching Falls Cable Access, Spectrum Channel 13. We're coming to you live tonight. Menominee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium. Petrov Jeskowitz Field. It is Friday the 13th. It is senior night. It is rainy. It is windy. It's miserable for those on the field, but the Hardy fans are here still cheering them on. For the ones that have been here all night, most of them have stuck this one out. And Menominee Falls looking to win this season finale, push them into a nice upswing heading into the playoffs. As again, they lead 44-13 into the visiting West Allis Central Bulldogs. It is second down for the Bulldogs when we come back. 12 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Second and 7 here for West Allis Central. Little outside pitch from Davis to Wickersheim. Wickersheim scoots ahead to about the 24-yard line. And that'll make it 3rd and 3 for the Bulldogs.
3rd and 3 from the 24.
Davis Jr. waits. Good snap. We have flags and we have movement on West Allis Central, so that will back them up 5.
We'll start Bulldogs.
Make it 3rd and 8 now for the Bulldogs. Third and 8 from the Menominee Falls 29-yard line. Dallas Central gets himself set.
Ball's on the 29-yard line, 3rd and 8.
5 receivers, 3-man bunch on the near side, 2 up top. Davis Jr. drops. Throws complete.
Davis' pass complete to Noack Smith.
Gets out to Noack Smith, but he is going to be short of the first down.
Johnson.
So that's going to bring up a 4th down decision here. Probably not much of a decision as they're trailing here in the fourth quarter by a considerable amount. Fourth and 5 for the Bulldogs. This ball is spotted at the Menominee Falls 26-yard line. So currently they've got to get to right in between the 21 and the 22.
From the 26.
They are going to attempt the field goal here. Angelo Cruz. Man runs on late, and that is blocked by the Phoenix.
The field goal is blocked.
That would have been a 43-yard attempt had they connected, but Eli Elm comes through and extends and gets the block nicely on that one. So Menominee Falls takes over. 1st and 10 for the Phoenix. They will start right where West Allis Central stopped.
26-yard line. Balls at their own 26.
Kershaw with the give to Holseth. Holseth straight ahead across the 30, up to the 31, almost gets to the 32. Pick up a 5 there on first down. Looks like they'll give them the 32, so pick up a 6. 2nd and 4 for the Phoenix.
2nd and 4 from the 32.
Holseth straight ahead.
Mason Holseth.
He is wrestled down just short of the 40-yard line, 35-yard line. He'll bring up 3rd and a long 1. Pinero in on that tackle. He's been active tonight. Called his name more than a few times.
2nd and 1.
And the wind picks up a little harder.
Third and one.
Kirshner with Holseth behind him. 3 wide receivers. And Kirshner will keep, roll right, throw back across, and he completes, connecting with Corey Johnson. Johnson out across midfield, down to about the 44-yard line, 43-yard line. First down, Menominee Falls. Menominee Falls keeping the clock running, keeping the chains moving, keeping that West Allis Central offense off the field. Trying to bring this game to a close. First and 10 from the West Allis Central 43-yard line. Sorry, I was reading the scoreboard and not looking at the field. Holseth gives and gets, tries the right side. Short pickup. One, maybe two.
Holseth on the carry.
Second down for the Phoenix. Pickup of one, so it'll be second and 9 here. Holseth gets the ball straight ahead across the 40, up to the 35, maybe the 34. Holseth, close, don't keeper. Think he'll quite have the first down. Let's see where they spot this.
And Tapia.
Just short of the 34, so it'll be
34-yard line.
Third and one for the Phoenix.
Third and one.
See what they do here. The last couple times they've been in this third and short, they have play actioned and had Kirshner roll out. But this one, Holseth straight ahead. Holseth down to the 31-yard line, and that'll be first down, Menominee Falls.
Tackled by Sanders and Austin. First and 10, Menominee Falls.
So first and 10 for the Phoenix from the West Allis Central 32-yard line. They keep those chains moving and that clock running. Kirshner rolls right, throws, connects with Holseth out across the 25 to the 20, first down to the 16-yard line. First down, Menominee Falls.
Hit by Brister. First and 10 Falls.
Pickup of about 15 on that one for the Phoenix.
At the 17-yard line.
Holseth did a nice job on that last one, getting lost in the line. Coming out underneath, rolling with Kirshner. Easy pitch catch, first down. Kirshner keeps straight ahead across the 15. Kirshner breaks it to the outside, down across the 10 to the 5. Kirshner into the end zone. Touchdown, Menominee Falls. Apologize, ladies and gentlemen. The weather has forced us into a one-camera game here tonight, and the building pillar got in the way there at the completion of Wilson Kirshner's touchdown. But trust us, he scored. Menominee Falls now 50-13 over West Allis Central. Now it off on for the extra point. Snap, hold, kick. Ooh! And that one just squeaks over, but it is good. So, situation we find ourselves in, 6:09 remaining. Menominee Falls leading 51-13 over West Allis Central. And the Phoenix about to kick it back to the Bulldogs. Good night for the Menominee Falls offense. Anytime you can score 51 points, it's a good night. Defense has done a nice job tonight, too. Only one drive that actually ended in a touchdown. The other was a punt return, so pretty limited opportunities there for West Allis Central to get in the end zone tonight playing against this Menominee Falls defense. Keneal Turner-Baskin and Acklin Nowak-Smith deep for the Bulldogs. Owen Moser will kick it away for Menominee Falls. And Moser's kick.
Oh, and Moser kicks to the ball.
Sends this one deep. Hits at the 10, skips, but
goes out of bounds.
Finds the sidelines, and the yellow hanky comes out.
35-yard line.
So West Dallas Central will bring this one out to the 35, and that is where their offense will take over. Not sure what the holdup is here. West Dallas Central, five receivers with a four-man stack up at the top, one man down at the bottom. Davis Jr. in the quarterback. He looks, but nothing there. Tries to keep and run. And he is catapulted forward and ends up coming down at the
Davis ball carrier.
West Dallas Central 39-yard line. Pickup of four, second and six. Willie Newman split up top. Brister in the backfield with Davis Jr. Three wide receivers down at the bottom of your screen. Give is to Brister off the right side. Brister out across the 45 to the 50. Spins, stays on his feet. He is brought down at the Menominee Falls 43-yard line. First down for Brookfield Central.
Met by Walker. Help on the play from Hoffman.
So as we dip below 5 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter,
first and
10 for the Bulldogs from the Menominee Falls 43-yard line. Davis's pass. Intended for Thomas Dorn. That falls incomplete. Second and 10 for the Bulldogs.
Covered up by Namini. Second and 10 at the 43.
Second and 10 now for the Bulldogs. Five wide receivers, two at the top, three in the near side. Man goes in motion. Little shovel there. Aiden Wickersheim. Little trouble with the exchange, but Wickersheim tries to make the most of it, but is tracked down and dropped. Apologize, I don't have number 71 on my roster that was provided to me.
Ball's on the 48-yard line, the Falls.
So back them up to the 48-yard line. That'll bring up
check that second and 15.
Second and 15 now for the Bulldogs. Davis Jr. and Wickersheim in the backfield. Davis Jr. loads up, throws that one up for grabs, and that is intercepted, picked off. Evan Hoffman brings the ball
intercepted
all the way back to the West Dallas Central 40-yard line, first and 10, Menominee Falls.
Picked off by Evan Hoffman.
Fortunately, it looked like Davis threw that one just sort of up for grabs. Hoffman able to camp under it, make the interception, secure the catch. And get a nice return out of it also. So first and 10 for the Phoenix.
First and 10 Menominee Falls at the Central 41-yard line.
The West Dallas Central 41-yard line.
Give us some time now.
And nice to see Mitchell Hutchinson back in. Timeout, West Dallas Central.
Timeout on the field.
West Dallas Central wanted to make sure they have the right defense to be able to stop this drive by Menominee Falls so they could potentially make their comeback. It's the current score with 2:09 remaining, Menominee Falls 51, West Dallas Central 13. Menominee Falls offense scoots back onto the field, and Hutchison and Spence set to do it again in the backfield for the Phoenix. All right, we are set. Another low snap. Hutchison recovers. Goes straight ahead. Hutchinson picks up maybe one. A second and 9 for the Phoenix. Definitely had a little bit of a challenge with exchanges here the last few when Hutchison's been in. Not sure if we have a different center than what works with Kirshner. Can't quite see the numbers for the linemen there.
Second and 9 at the 40-yard line.
So here we go, second and 9. Hutchison gives to Spence. Spence over the right side, across the 40, up ahead to about the 41-yard line. Pickup of 4 on that one. Sorry, the 36-yard line.
From Jesse.
That'll make it 3rd and 5 for the Phoenix.
Ball spotted on the 36-yard line.
36. Looked like he got a little further than that, so. Liam Richardson, Nicholas Lopez Leon, and Kevin Cooper in at wide receiver for Menominee Falls.
From the 36.
Hutchison with the snap. Give it to Spence. Spence tries the right side, cuts it back. Up ahead, gets down near the 30-yard line. Let's see where this is spotted, but looks like he has enough for the Menominee Falls first down. We'll know here in a moment. Oh, they're spotting him just short. 4th and 1 for the Phoenix. We drop under 30 seconds. And Menominee Falls is just going to let the clock run down here at this point in time. So they will line up at midfield.
And senior night contest is history. The happy final tonight, Menominee Falls 51, West Dallas Central 13. Fans, please drive home carefully to get there safely. Please enjoy your evening and your weekend.
And
as we await the announcement,
there is the horn. Your final, Menominee Falls 51, West Dallas Central 13, for senior night here at Schumann Stadium, Petrov Jeskowitz Field, as the Menominee Falls Phoenix win their season finale to move themselves to 6-3 overall, 5-2 in conference. West Dallas Central falls to 0-9 on the season and 0-6 in conference. And Menominee Falls will get set to find out who they play in that first round of the playoffs on Sunday. I'd like to thank you again for all for joining us here. We are Falls Cable Access. Had a lot of fun bringing you Falls football this fall season. Hope you enjoyed it. Again, your final score tonight, Menominee Falls 51, West Dallas Central 13. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Hope you had a good time. Good night.